In this video, we will discuss the impact echo test method and how it can help building inspectors and structural engineers in the inspection, testing, and evaluation of concrete structures. Impact echo method is an advanced, non-destructive test method for structural integrity testing of concrete structures. The test has been widely used to evaluate thin concrete plates such as bridge decks and parking garage slabs. The ASTM C1383-15 sets the standard test method for measuring the P wave speed in the thickness of concrete plates using the impact echo method. Different technical committees have also studied the effectiveness of the impact echo test for evaluating concrete elements. The test can be used for various engineering applications, including evaluating structural integrity in concrete elements, estimating crack depth in concrete, and estimating the thickness of concrete components. The concept behind the technique is to excite concrete elements using a steel impactor and monitoring wave propagation in concrete. A commercial impact echo test device has three main components. One, a set of steel ball impactors with various diameters. Two, a high precision motion transducer and data acquisition system. Three, a device for displaying measurements and analysis. The test works based on studying the wave propagation of compression waves, P, in concrete. For the thin plates, studying waveform in the time domain can be quite challenging. Therefore, the measurements are generally studied in the frequency domain. Fast Fourier transform is used for this purpose. By identifying the peak frequencies in the frequency domain, one will be able to evaluate the overall thickness of concrete and the integrity of the components, such as delamination and major cracks. Different impactors should be used for different concrete thicknesses. For example, a small diameter ball impactor is ideal for investigating thin concrete elements. In contrast, a larger diameter will be necessary for thick concrete elements. The impact echo method can be used to evaluate the P wave speed in concrete. To do so, two motion transducers are placed at a spacing of B. A steel ball impactor is used to strike a concrete surface. The generated P wave is sensed by each transducer at two different time steps, T1 and T2. By dividing the distance by the arrival time difference, one can estimate the P wave speed in concrete. To estimate the overall thickness of the concrete element, one motion transducer is placed on one side of the concrete element. Next, a steel ball impactor is used to strike the concrete surface. The waveform is then studied in the frequency domain, and the peak frequency associated with back-end reflection is identified. Finally, a mathematical formula is used to estimate the concrete thickness. Depending on the geometry of the element, a shape correction factor should be applied to the measurements. The impact echo method can also be used to evaluate the crack depth in concrete components. First, two motion transducers are placed on either side of the crack. A steel impactor is then used to strike the concrete surface. The arrival time of the P wave at the transducers is then used to calculate the depth of the concrete crack. Impact echo is an effective method in evaluating concrete elements. However, field conditions might affect the accuracy and resolution of the test results. It is crucial to make sure that the transducer or impact echo probe is stabilized on the concrete surface. The boundary and edge effects can make the interpretation of the results quite challenging. Therefore, it is essential to perform the test far from the edges of concrete walls of the slabs. Finally, when testing large areas for identifying the boundary of the delamination regions, it is important to adopt a fine test grid to increase the resolution of the heat map. To learn more about F'C and the non-destructive solutions that we offer, visit our website at fprimec.com.